Third one, color property. You know, we see different colors by the scattering of colloidal solutions. Color of colloidal solution mainly depends on color of CS, means colloidal solution, depends on the lambda, that means wavelength of light used. Wavelength of light used. This wavelength in turn depends on, this wavelength in turn depends on size and shape of colloidal particles. Size and shape of colloidal particles. Now, smaller particles, smaller colloidal particles scatter, smaller particles scatter longer wavelength, whereas larger particles scatter shorter wavelength. If colloidal particles are smaller, they scatter larger wavelengths or longer wavelengths. If colloidal particles are somewhat bigger, then they scatter shorter wavelengths. That's why if wavelength scattered changed, automatically color also changes. Similarly, spherical particles, based on the size I am explaining, spherical particles scatter red colored light, whereas disc like particles scatter blue light. So in that way, shape also decides the color of the colloidal solution. If colloidal particles are in spherical shape, they scatter red light. If these colloidal particles are in disc-like shape, then they scatter blue light. Similarly, you know, not only on the size shape, the manner in which the scatter light received, either reflected light is received, transmitted light received, so based on that also colloidal solution appears in different colors. So when you take a mixture of water and milk plus water, this colloidal solution appears, this colloidal solution appears red when viewed by reflected light, but blue when viewed by transmitted light. So the color of colloidal solution depends on the manner in which the light received. If the observer received reflected light from the mixture, this milk and water appears red. If the transmitted light is received, then that colloidal solution of this mixture appears blue. So similarly, in a colloidal solution also, in the preparation of a colloidal solution, the color of solution changes when the size of particles changes. See, first gold salt, the finest gold salt appears red. Gold salt, see the colors of gold salt when the size increases. First it appears red. when the gold particles are very smaller, but in colloidal range. Colloidal range means 10 power minus 9 to 10 power minus minus 6. What is the colloidal range? 10 power minus 9 meters to 10 power minus 6 meters. This is the colloidal range. So initially, let us start with 10 power minus 9 meters. If gold particles are in the range 10 power minus 9 meters, then what is the color? Red color. Simply, when the size increases, a little bit increases, it becomes purple. Still, there is an increase in the size, then it becomes blue. Still, it increases, then finally, it gets golden color. So, when the size of gold particles reach this value around 10 power minus 6, then it appears golden color. So, have you seen this difference? When size of in this way, along this direction, size is increasing. Size of gold particles, size of gold, colloidal gold solution increases. So, size increases in this direction. When size of gold particles increases, here gold particle means not a single gold atom. In golds are, gold atoms, aggregates are present, not a single gold atom. A single gold atom is not in the colloidal range. Number of gold atoms, they aggregate. Around 1000 or more than 1000 gold atoms, they aggregate, simply form a colloidal range particle. So, this aggregation here to show red color, that aggregated particle lesser, that aggregated colloidal particle contains lesser number of atoms. Here somewhat more number of gold atoms in the aggregates. Here further more. Here they reached, the aggregates reached the highest size. So, in that way, when the size of gold particles increases in the aggregates, so as a result, its color also changes. So, color of a colloidal solution depends on which factors? Wavelength. This wavelength depends on size and shape. If shape is spherical, it shows red. See here, spherical particles scatter red light, whereas disc-like particles exhibit blue light. Similarly, smaller particles scatter longer wavelength and larger particles scatter shorter wavelengths. In the manner in which the light received also changes the color of colloidal solutions. For example, here discussed milk and water mixture. It appears red when viewed by reflected light, but blue when viewed by transmitted light. Similarly, gold salt, when its size increases, its color changes. So, remember this color change of gold salt. Red, purple, blue, golden. So, when the gold particles are finest, that means very small, gold color, red color. When the gold particles are in the extremely higher size, then gold salt exhibits golden color. Okay, so this is about color property.